the Glassback Park receiving funds from state entity in regards to the turf field, the facility over here, the park. So I was gonna kind of like sit back and not, but I'm jumping on this because I don't know how you can go in partnership with somebody just on a, just by talking. Because I did a follow-up on Monsignor Owens from day one, from when the Parks, the Parks Department went into partnership with Green Acres to renovate the Monsignor Owens field over there. And I just happened to, my family's been in town since the 1920s, so I honestly picked up the phone and said to Green Acres, I don't understand how you can go in partnership when there's certain issues with that park that they're not in compliance with state laws. And there was a list of them. I said, can you check this out? Can you check that out? Meaning, can you check out handicap accessibility? Can you check out the parking? Can you check out access to the park? Check it out, please. I understood that it was open, declared open space from day one, and I always thought I knew it was open space. It was on the books until 2015, when it was listed as open space. Okay, so you know, I kind of like kept in touch with the state because I actually see the Century full part. It used to be our manufacturing district, and people not conforming, so they say like the houses don't belong there. I don't believe that, but anyway, we happen to be here since the 1920s. Now, this park was not in compliance. There was a certain string of employees there. There was a list like 7 or 8 deep with things that didn't conform or weren't right compliance or not complying with the state law. Now, I just stuck with it because the density, because of all of these apartments that are all over the place, like I would say 10 times more the amount of density. And I can remember 30 years ago coming to this meeting, which I never saw anyone of you commissioners at these meetings from 30 years ago. It's when you guys got in the office that I see here. I've been coming to these meetings, and I went toe-to-toe with Frank Cacciola asking him, why are you dumping down where that park is supposed to be a section for parking cars? Never answered the question. Okay. I don't know, why you're dumping it. Like, people are trying to live and stop like rodents and all of that vermin stuff and watch out for their property. And I don't know. I felt that I had the right to come here and say, hey, look, you know, that's designated parking, that's open space. And he never answered my question. But yet, Mr. Cacciola's name is on the Parks Department building. Mr. You have to, something has to warrant having your name on the building. Okay? And I want to stick to my neck of the woods, but when there was the creative playground, I'm sure people in that section up there weren't happy with the rats coming from the brook, and they just went to shambles. Okay? I lived through down here. Now, I want to ask Mr. Tucci, maybe you can answer this question another time. 5 years have gone by since 2012 when we went to partnership with Green Acres, okay? We received $183,000 until all the commotion came about when I picked up the phone. Now, I'm closing out on this, okay? Please. It takes a lot to come up here and screw your guts out. But anyway, we got a loan for $410,000. We have a balance of $150,000 that hasn't been paid until my last call was maybe 2 weeks ago, so I don't know. It went to restitution with Jenny Tempo and all the lawyers go there. Like, who pays for that? Who's paying for all this stuff here that we have to go to? As far as I know, the story changes. Now it's not open space up until September 14, 2015. It's not conservation land. Like, you know, they throw things around. And then to boot, which really got me aggravated, is when I got a referendum stationary from the state to preserve open space. I mean, like, I felt like somebody really, a dummy wrapped me in the butt.
Right.
I mean, could somebody answer this eventually? I mean, I wanted to face him, but this all started, it made my head click. About 15 minutes ago, when he mentioned getting grant money from the state entity for the last back part, when we can't even take care of it, how do you balance a budget?